I don't see a future to a truly sustainable energy economy without fusion energy. There's is and continues to be a lot of focus on deploying renewables. By the mid-2030s, that's going to start to change. Fusion is the power of the stars. It's what powers the sun, and it really is the most powerful form of energy in the entire universe. I think the biggest myth is that fusion is still a long way off, but things are happening so quickly in the fusion sector right now, it's almost hard to keep up. We are in a position to actually bring fusion to the energy markets, and that will really open the door to a practical way of achieving net zero carbon emissions. There really is a real opportunity to put fusion on the power grid in the mid-2030s. Fusion is in the transition from basic research and development to commercialization. This is a really exciting time for fusion energy, the most powerful form of energy in the entire universe. And it's very simple. At the conditions at the center of the star, you achieve the temperatures and pressures needed to combine the very lightest atoms, hydrogen, and turn them into helium. And in that process of nuclear fusion, you release an incredible amount of energy, and that energy can be harnessed to provide the power that's going to support the energy transition to a more sustainable future. The center of the sun is at 15 million degrees Celsius and more than 100 billion atmospheres. And so creating those conditions on Earth in a way that is repeatable has been the challenge that has faced fusion and the science of fusion for more than half a century. My name is Chris Mowry, and I am the CEO of Type One Energy. It's a private fusion company, and I also have the honor of chairing the SMI's Fusion Task Force. The fusion process is completely clean. It emits no carbon dioxide, no greenhouse gases. There's no long-term nuclear waste from this. It is a completely safe process. And of course, it creates a very significant amount of energy. The fuel source for fusion, for the most common type of fusion, is really ultimately water. And actually, if you think about it, from that perspective, fusion is unique in that it has no geographic dependency and it's on demand. It's not an intermittent source of energy the way many renewables are. So in that way, it's a great complement to the future mix of energy, which certainly will have renewables as part of it. The types of fusion that basically try to create this very, very high temperature gas, really a plasma. Typically, they're contained inside of a magnetic bottle. There have been a lot of advances in this regard that are actually things that can allow us to make more practical, more compact fusion machines. High temperature superconducting magnets, which create very strong magnetic fields that let us hold this fusion plasma in a smaller configuration and therefore let us make machines that are smaller and more compact. There's a number of different approaches to fusion energy, but ultimately with the advent of modern supercomputing, we've really now had the capability to actually predict and model how the fusion process works and design machines that can actually reproduce that. The science of fusion practically is mature. We can actually now pivot to focusing on the commercialization, which is taking those processes that have been developed in laboratories and industrializing them. It's almost the handoff, if you will, from the pure scientists to the engineers. A lot of people ask when fusion is going to be ready to scale. Fusion will be ready when society needs it to be ready. By the mid-2030s, the maximum practical amount of renewables on power grids is going to be achieved, and so that's why we're focused on deploying the first fusion pilot power plants over the next decade, so that by the second half of the 2030s, we're really ready to scale fusion energy aggressively and globally in order to continue the transition to net zero carbon. The commercialization of fusion energy is going to require a significant amount of capital. Society needs to mobilize resources in order to make the shift from currently how it produces energy, which is fossil fuel intensive. The underlying policies which govern the energy industry need to be reshaped by governments around the world. If you want to have this incredible technology in the portfolio of energy mix in the future, we're going to have to invest in it. The pathway for fusion to really be commercialized and adopted at scale is now for the fusion industry to connect itself to the broader value chain of companies and organizations. So this is everything from the supply chain of materials and minerals and equipment to the asset managers, to the owners and off-takers, to regulators, to the financing and to the insurance, all of the things that really have to come together in this broader value chain. There have been a number of really, really important milestones that have been achieved over the past 5 years that really have opened the door to commercializing fusion energy over the next decade. I believe that we are in a position to actually bring fusion to the energy markets, and that will really open the door to achieving net zero carbon emissions and completing this energy transition journey. Mm-hmm.